Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on the gate question paper in mechanical engineering subjects. And this is lecture number 36. So we are going to discuss few questions in the convection heat transfer from various gate question papers. The first question from 1988 question paper: for the fluid flowing over a flat plate with the Prandtl number greater than unity, the thermal bond layer for laminar forced convection, we have four options, is thinner than the hydrodynamic bond layer, has thickness equal to zero, is of the same thickness of the hydrodynamic bond layer, is thicker than the hydrodynamic bond layer. The relative thickness of thermal and velocity bond layer depends on the Prandtl number. For Prandtl number equal to 1 for like air and gases, the delta T is equal to delta. So delta is the hydrodynamic bond layer thickness and delta T is the thermal bond layer thickness. For Prandtl number very much lower than 1 like liquid metal, delta T is greater than delta. So thermal bond layer thickness is thicker than the hydrodynamic bond layer thickness. When the Prandtl number is very much greater than 1, ethylene glycol engine oil like the fluid, ethylene glycol engine oil, the thermal bond layer thickness is very much lower than the hydrodynamic bond layer thickness. And the condition here, the Prandtl number is greater than unity. So for Prandtl number greater than unity, thermal bond layer thickness is less than the hydrodynamic bond layer thickness. So the answer here is option A. The thermal bond layer thickness is thinner than the hydrodynamic bond layer thickness. The next question, in pool boiling, the highest heat transfer coefficient occurs in subcooled boiling region, nucleate boiling zone, partial film boiling zone and the film boiling zone. So this is the boiling curve for various zones are shown here, natural convection boiling, nucleate boiling, transition boiling, film boiling. And the highest heat transfer coefficient will occur in the nucleate boiling zone. Next question, for air near atmospheric condition flowing over a flat plate, the laminar thermal bond layer is thicker than the hydrodynamic bond layer, whether this is true or false. For air, Prandtl number equal to 0.7, so for which is approximately taken as 1, so for air delta equal to delta T, thermal bond layer thickness is equal to the velocity bound layer thickness. So the statement given here is false. The heat transfer coefficient for free convection in gases, forced convection in the gases and the vapor, and for boiling of water lie respectively in the range of 5 to 15, 20 to 200, 3000 to 50,000. So first value is free convection in the gases, second value is forced convection in the gases and the vapor, and third range is the boiling of water. So the range of convection heat transfer coefficient, free convection 2 to 25, forced convection in gases 25 to 250, and the boiling heat transfer 2500 to 1 lakh. So among the four options given here, so the correct answer is option A. So the for free convection the gases 5 to 15, forced convection the gases 20 to 200, and the boiling 3000 to 50,000 watts per meter square Kelvin. Next question, for flow of fluid over a heated plate, the flowing fluid properties are known. Viscosity is 0.001 Pascal second, specific heated constant pressure is 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, thermal conductivity is 1 watts per meter Kelvin, the hydrodynamic bond layer thickness at a specific location on the plate is 1 millimeter. The thermal bond layer thickness at the same location is, we have four options, 0.001 millimeter, 0.01 millimeter, 1 millimeter and 1000 millimeter. We calculate the given data. Viscosity is 0.001 Pascal second, Cp is 1, K equal to 1 and delta equal to 1 millimeter. We calculate the Prandtl number. So Prandtl number equal to mu Cp by K. So mu equal to 0.001. Cp is 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, which is 1000 divided by K equal to 1 equal to 1. So the Prandtl number equal to 1. For Prandtl number equal to 1, delta equal to delta T. So we have delta equal to 1 millimeter. Thermal bond length, well, I mean the hydrodynamic bond length thickness is given as 1 millimeter. So the delta T is also 1 millimeter. That is the answer. Delta equal to delta T. Next question from 2009 question paper. A coolant fluid at 30 degree Celsius flows over a heated flat plate maintained at a constant temperature of 100 degree Celsius. The boundary layer temperature distribution at a given location on the plate may be approximated as T equal to 30 plus 70 exponential of minus Y, where Y is in meter. Y is the distance normal to the plate and T is the temperature in degree Celsius. If the thermal conductivity of the fluid is 1 watts per meter Kelvin, the local heat transfer coefficient in watts per meter square Kelvin at that location will be 0.2, 1, 5 and 10. The answer is 1. We will see how in the next slide. The given parameter, temperature of the fluid 30 degree Celsius, wall temperature 100 degree Celsius, temperature distribution T equal to 30 plus 70 exponential of minus Y and K thermal conductivity equal to 1 watts per meter Kelvin. So the heat conducted to the surface, that is equal to heat convected to the air fluid, that is the principle. So heat conducted is minus Ka dT by dx at Y equal to 0. Heat convected is Ha into Tw minus T infinity. So this A is getting cancelled. So K equal to minus 1. dT by dx equal to 70 into minus 1 into e to the power of minus y. So differentiating this equation, 70. Differentiating exponential of minus y, minus 1 into e to the power of minus y at y equal to 0, which is equal to H into 100 minus 30. So 1 into 70 minus 1 e to the power 0 at y equal to 0, e to the power 0 equal to 1 equal to H into 70. So H equal to 1 watts per meter square Kelvin. So the heat transfer coefficient is 1 watts per meter square Kelvin. The next question from 2014 question paper. Consider a two-dimensional laminar flow over a long cylinder as shown in the figure below. So this is the cylinder and there is a flow, two-dimensional flow. The free stream velocity is U infinity and the free stream temperature is T infinity is lower than the cylinder surface temperature Ts. The local heat transfer coefficient is minimum at a point 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4 points where the location where the heat transfer coefficient is minimum. That is the question. For laminar flow, separation occurs approximately at 82 degree. So in the direction of the flow, 82 degree, point 2 where the heat transfer coefficient will be minimum. So this is the point. Approximately here there will be separation of the flow. So the heat transfer coefficient minimum at this point 2. The answer is two. The next question from 2014 question paper. For laminar forced convection over a flat plate, if the free stream velocity increased by a factor of 2, the heat transfer coefficient remains the same, decreases by a factor of square root of 2, raises by a factor of square root of 2 and raises by a factor of 4. So for laminar forced convection over a flat plate, we have Nusselt number equal to 0.332, Reynolds number to the power 0.5 and Prandtl number to the power 0.33. So here velocity is involved in the Reynolds number. So heat transfer, Nusselt number, so it gives the heat transfer coefficient is proportional to the velocity to the power 0.5 because all the other parameters are constant. So H2 by H1 equal to 2V by H2 by H1 equal to V2 by V1 to the power 0.5. So V2 equal to 2V. What is given, the velocity is given by a factor of 2. So 2V by V, it is square root of 2. So H2 equal to H1 into square root of 2. That is the answer. So the heat transfer coefficient increases, raises by a factor of square root of 2. That is the correct answer to the question. Next question, again from 2014 question paper. Match the group A and B. So group A, we have Biot number, Grashof number, Prandtl number, Reynolds number. And group B, we have ratio of buoyancy to the viscous force, ratio of internal inertia force to the viscous force, ratio of momentum to the thermal diffusivity, ratio of internal thermal resistance to the boundary layer thermal resistance. So we have P4, Q1. So we just define. Biot number is the ratio of internal thermal resistance to the boundary layer. So, P4. Grashof number, it is the Grashof number is the ratio of buoyancy force to the viscous force, that is Q1. Then R, Prandtl number, is the ratio of momentum to the thermal diffusivity, so R3. Then S, Reynolds number, is the ratio of inertia force to the viscous force, R2. So P4, Q2, R3, S1. So S2, that is the correct answer. Option A is the correct answer. So you may find the definition here. Biot number, resistant to the conduction to the resistance to the convection. Prandtl number, diffusivity of momentum to the diffusivity of heat. Grashof number is the ratio of buoyancy forces to the viscous forces acting on the fluid. Reynolds number is the ratio of inertia force to the viscous force. Then next question from 2015 question paper. Blasius equation related to the boundary layer theory is a third order linear partial differential equation, third order non-linear partial differential equation, second order non-linear ordinary differential equation, third order non-linear ordinary differential equation. So the answer is third order non-linear ordinary differential equation. Next question from 2015 question paper. For flow of viscous fluid over a flat plate, if the fluid temperature is same as the plate temperature. So fluid temperature is the same as the plate temperature. Thermal boundary layer is thinner than the velocity boundary layer, thicker than the velocity boundary layer, of the same thickness as the velocity boundary layer, not at all formed. Look at the question once again. The fluid temperature is same as the plate temperature. So when the fluid temperature and plate temperatures are equal, there is no temperature difference. There is no heat transfer between the plate and the fluid. So the formation of thermal boundary layer is not at all there. So there is no thermal boundary layer. Thermal boundary layer is not at all formed. The thermal boundary layer forms only when there is a temperature difference between the surface and the fluid. Next question from 2015 question paper. In a laminar flow of air, Prandtl number equal to 0.7 over a heated plate, if delta and delta T denotes the hydrodynamic boundary layer and thermal boundary layer thickness respectively, then delta equal to delta T, delta is greater than delta T, delta is less than delta T, and delta equal to 0 and delta T is not equal to 0. So for Prandtl number less than 1, so delta is less than delta T. So the hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness is less than the thermal boundary layer thickness. This is the correct answer. The ratio of momentum diffusivity to the thermal diffusivity is called as Prandtl number, Nusselt number, Biot number, Lewis number. So the definition, Prandtl number is the diffusivity of momentum to the diffusivity of heat. So the answer is Prandtl number. Next question from the 2016 question paper. Grashof number signifies the ratio of inertia force to viscous force, buoyancy force to viscous force, buoyancy force to inertia force to the surface tension force. So Grashof number is defined as the ratio of buoyancy force to the viscous force acting on the fluid. So the answer is option B, buoyancy force to viscous force. Next question, 2019 question paper. For a hydrodynamically and thermally fully developed laminar flow through a circular pipe of constant cross section, the Nusselt number at constant wall heat flux NuQ and that at the constant wall temperature NuT are related as NuQ, Nusselt number for constant heat flux is less than the Nusselt number for constant temperature. Nusselt number NuQ is equal to NuT. NuQ equal to NuT whole square, NuQ is greater than NuT. So, for fully developed flow, Nusselt number for constant heat flux condition is 4.36. Nusselt number for constant wall temperature condition is 3.66. So, the answer is Nusselt number for constant heat flux condition is greater than Nusselt number for constant wall temperature condition for fully developed laminar flow in a circular pipe. The constants are applicable only for specified conditions. Fully developed laminar flow through a circular pipe. The next question from 2019 question paper. A thin vertical flat plate of length of height L and infinite width perpendicular to the plane of the figure. Width is perpendicular to the plane of the figure is losing heat to the surrounding by natural convection. The temperature of the plate surround temperature of plate surrounding and the properties of fluid are constant. The relationship between average Nusselt number and the Rayleigh number is given by Nusselt number equal to K into Rayleigh number to the power 0.25, where K is a constant. The length scales for Nusselt and the Rayleigh number are the height of the plate. So length is measured. So H is for height, we take the length of the plate. The height of the plate is increased by 16L, keeping all the other factors are constant. If the average heat transfer coefficient for the first plate is H1 and then for the second plate is H2, the ratio of H1 by H2 is dash. So this is the initial condition. We have the length of the plate equal to L and we have the Nusselt number equal to K into the Rayleigh number to the power 0.25. G is 9.8 meter per second square. Now the length is increased by 16 times of L. Now what is the ratio of H1 and H2? H1 is the heat transfer coefficient for the present case. H2 is the heat transfer coefficient when the length is increased by 16L. So the answer is 2. We will see how in the next slide. So for free conversion, Nusselt number equal to K into Rayleigh number to the power 0.25. So we take Nusselt number is K G beta delta T L to the power 3 divided by nu square whole to the power 0.25. Now everything is constant. So G beta delta T nu, everything is taken as constant. L is the parameter varying. So Nusselt number equal to HL by K is proportional to L to the power 0.75. So H equal to, again K is constant, L is taken to the other side. So L, H is proportional to L to the power 0.75 minus 1 equal to minus 0.25. So H1 by H2 equal to L1 by L2 to the power minus 0.25. So this is 1 by 16. So L1 by L2 equal to 1 by 16. 1 by 2 to the power 4 equal to the power minus 0.25, or 2 to the power minus 4 minus 0.25. So H1 by H2 equal to 2. So the heat transfer coefficient for the first case will be 2 times of the heat transfer coefficient for the second case. Next question from 1992 question paper. A fluid flowing over a flat plate has the following properties. Dynamic viscosity 25 into 10 power minus 6 kilogram per meter second. Specific heat 2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Thermal conductivity 0.05 watts per meter Kelvin. The hydrodynamic boundary layer is measured as 0.5 millimeter. Thickness of the thermal boundary layer would be 0.1 millimeter, 0.5 millimeter, 1 millimeter, none of the above. And write down the given data. Mu equal to 25 into 10 power 6. Cp equal to 2. K equal to 0.05. Delta H equal to 0.5. So we calculate the Prandtl number mu Cp by K. So 25 into 10 power 6 in 2000 divided by 0.05 equal to 1. So for Prandtl number equal to 1, delta H equal to delta T, which is 0.5. So the answer is 0.5. So match the list 1 and list 2 here. Fourier number, Weber number, Grassof number, Skimmitt number. On the other side, we have surface tension, forced convection, natural convection, radiation, transient heat conduction and mass diffusion. So Fourier number is connected with the transient heat conduction, Weber number is connected with the surface tension, Grassof number for natural convection and Skimmitt number for the mass diffusion. So these are all the matching correct answer for the number, non-dimensional number given in the list 1. Next question. In 2001 question paper, water with the Prandtl number equal to 6 flows over a flat plate which is heated over the entire length. Which one of the following relationship between hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness delta and the thermal boundary thickness delta T is true? So delta equal to delta T, delta T is less than delta, delta is less than delta T, delta is greater than delta T cannot be predicted. So for Prandtl number is greater than 1, much greater than 1. So delta T is less than delta. So the answer is option C. Delta is greater than delta T. The next question from 2002 question paper. The properties of mercury at 300 Kelvin are density 13,529 kilogram per meter cube. Cp value 0.1393 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Dynamic viscosity 0.1523 in 10 power minus 2 Newton second meter square. And thermal conductivity is 8.54 watts per meter Kelvin. The Prandtl number of mercury is We have four options: 0.0248, 2.48, 24.8, and 248. So we write down the given data. So all the datas are given. We have to just calculate the Prandtl number. Prandtl number equal to mu Cp by k. So 0.1523 in 10 power minus 2 into 139.3. So the value given Cp equal to 0.1393, so which is 139.3 joules per kilogram Kelvin, divided by 8.54 equal to 2.48. So the answer is 2.48. Prandtl number for the mercury is 2.48. The next question from 2003 question paper. Consider laminar boundary layer over a heated flat plate. The free stream velocity is u infinity. At some distance x from the leading edge, the velocity boundary thickness is delta v and the thermal boundary thickness is delta t. If the Prandtl number is greater than 1, then delta v is greater than delta t, delta v is less than delta t, delta v is delta t function of u infinity, delta v is delta t function of x to the power minus 1 by 2. So this is the condition. And we have Prandtl number equal to 1, delta t equal to delta, Prandtl number is less than 1, delta t is greater than delta, Prandtl number is greater than 1, delta t is less than delta. So here, if the Prandtl number is greater than 1, so Prandtl number is greater than 1, thermal boundary layer thickness is less than the velocity boundary layer thickness. So option A is the correct answer. Velocity boundary layer thickness is greater than the thermal boundary layer thickness. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subject. I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here, and the solution to the gate question paper is also uploaded in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better preparation and passing the gate examination. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. We'll meet again in another video on the solution for the gate question papers.